Thank you. You may be seated at this time. Good morning, parents, special guest, Ms. Debbie Holly, school board member, Ms. Lydia Martin, executive director of St. Lucie Public Schools, Ms. Susie Lewis, guest speaker, assistant principal, Ms. Alexandra Laudis. A special greeting to all of you. It is with extreme pleasure that I welcome our class of 2023. 2023, you ask? Yes, 2023. This is a class that made it here today. And right now, we are so excited and so extremely proud of all of our fifth graders. Forgive me if I get a little teary-eyed, because just this past Saturday, I had my own senior graduate from high school and get ready to go off to college. And as I look at these boys and girls, our future generation, I get emotional because I've watched many of them from first grade when I first entered the halls of Lawnwood to this moment now. I've watched the triumphs, I've watched the trials, I've watched the tribulations, and I've watched all of them on this journey. And in thinking back, it didn't seem as if just yesterday when they were entering the halls of kindergarten, some of you pre-K, that they were getting ready to graduate. It happens in a blink of an eye. Now look at them. They are ready to take on the world. And you wonder, do they have the tools to be successful? Yes, they do. Let's take a look at what has prepared them for their future success. Parents, I was not sitting in your seat too long ago. I grumbled because I had to fight my son to get his Sunday best church shoes on. He didn't want to put them on and squish his toes, and he definitely did not want to walk down that aisle. But he did, and I had to spend all weekend long finding just the perfect outfit so that when I could take a picture and remember it in a photo story 12 years down the road, it would look just right. But as he walked across the stage and the flashbulb went off, it reminded me that he had his first tool for success on his blueprint for the future, which is a firm foundation. The foundation that has been built has come from your family's encouragement, your family's love, your family's push, and their drive. A solid foundation that will allow the structure to be built around it to hold up against anything. And speaking of structure, students, you have just that. You have the teachers, the bus drivers, the coaches, the tutors, the leaders, the readers. All of them give you that structural integrity that will help you have a successful life. Now, there might have been some fussing along the way by you, sometimes by me, and choices that you might not have always agreed to. But know that this structure, like walls on a house, will help support you in times of trouble, in times of great joy, and in times of triumph when you have met your goals and your dreams. Remember, pause. Take pride in your work, but never be boastful. And always be accountable for your actions. We are respectful of everything you do and everything we say, and we always make sure that we stay safe. Safety doesn't just mean in the physical sense. It means to develop those healthy friendships, those healthy relationships, and to establish the network of like-minded individuals who will help you reach your goals and your dreams. You have windows of opportunity opening before your very eyes. Like a cap on a graduate, the roof of a house is very important. It protects the house's foundation and structure from the elements of life. Your roof is being built right now, fifth graders. Allow your life's lessons learned from teachers, from your parents, from your principals. Help them put your tile on that roof to complete the final package. I challenge each and every leopard in here today to take this blueprint called life and make it a great one. We believe in you. We know you can do it. We know you have a great future ahead of you. Use your blueprint for success to build a better future for you and for the rest of the world. Thank you. Now I'd like to invite to the podium our Student Council President, Ms. Angelina Patterson Brooks, who will give her welcome message, followed by the introduction of our guest speaker. Angelina?
Good morning, Leopards. My name is Angelina Crooks, Student Council President. As your Student Council President, I'm here to congratulate all of us in moving up from our elementary years and becoming middle school students. It has been a great experience working with teacher staff and student council members. I'd like to thank my teacher, Ms. Barr. For example, science wasn't just reading a boring textbook. We had a real-life scientist named Dr. V come in and speak to us. We were studying the animal and human body, which led to the most exciting experience that I had at Lawnwood. That was when we got to hold the pig's heart. It was gross. I will always remember all the friends I've made and things I've learned at Lawnwood. Now that our journey has come to an end, I'm here to wish you all a great middle school experience. Remember to never give up and always do your best. Thank you and congratulations, class of 2023. School system from 1976 until 2013. In those 37 years, she taught 1 year at Seymour and the rest at Lawnwood Elementary. She taught kindergarten through fourth grade. During that time, she and her husband raised 3 sons and later had 9 grandchildren. She attended the University of Florida and Florida Atlantic University, where she received her master's degree in elementary education.
True. The dream provides the starter, but the rest
is up to you. It takes determination to fight until you win. The world has too many folk with dreams that might have been. Too many lazy wishers who sit around and whine. I might have lived a life worthwhile. Once, such a dream was mine. It takes a bit of doing, but a dream that's given you is worth all you can give it to make that dream come true. I was blessed a couple of weeks ago to attend a workshop with New York number one best-selling author and speaker, John C. Maxwell. He shared with us a gift that he received earlier. It was a book. It was entitled The Greatest Story Ever Told. He was shocked when he opened it to find a note from the giver. And then the rest of the book was blank. The note said, John, your life is before you. Fill these pages with kind acts, good thoughts, and matters of your heart. Write a great story with your life. That was John's invitation to become proactive in writing his own life story. The greatest story ever told can be told by you. Every day, you need to let your words and actions become a record of how you are making a positive difference in the lives of others. You could start today, making your decisions intentionally. You can write a great story with your life. So, how does this great story of your life begin? Well, it's not with excuses. It does not matter your circumstances. Poverty, abuse, divorced parents, negative words that are spoken into your life, or even peer pressure. You just need to make a conscious decision to make your dreams come true. To be the person your parents dreamed you could be the day you were born. I know from personal experience, you can overcome what others will see as obstacles to becoming the best you that you can be. But it does take determination to reach your dreams. But they are truly worth all that you can give them. So let's dream big. Let's reach for the stars. I think Tim McGraw has given us a great place to start in his song, Humble and Kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, and don't lie. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride. But always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget to turn back around and help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind. I'm looking forward to hearing and reading about some of the greatest stories ever told from students sitting right here in these front rows. Go forward and let your story begin. God bless.
We just are so thankful to have Ms. Lewis come back, and Ms. Lewis does not like public speaking, but she did a fantastic job, and I just have to say, the students, you chose well, because Ms. Lewis is a fan favorite, and we love you, love you, love you. Thank you. Woo! awards presented to all of our lepers. Now, this is difficult because many of our lepers have earned accolades the size of my arm length, and I could be here all day reading each and every award that they're presented. But today, when we call them up to the stage, starting first with Ms. Colby's class, I will call the students to the podium after their teacher has had a chance to give a few kind words, and we will read their name and each of their plaques to preserve. This time, we have awards ranging from honor roll, from student of the month, from attendance, from participation in clubs and organizations, all in a keepsake folder for them to take home and remember years later. And as the students do come up, I will have to share with you that these do come back around, especially when they get ready to graduate from high school and you get ready to tell a photo story. When you look back at this time and you see how they've been involved and how they have evolved, it will bring a tear to your eye. So I'm going to welcome at this time to the stage Ms. Lisa Coble, fifth grade teacher, and I'll ask our podium guest to step and form a receiving line after she concludes her speech for us to be able to shake hands and present the awards. Ms. Lisa Coble.
Welcome, family and friends. Students, as you begin to build your future, create your blueprint in middle school. Interesting thing you know about blueprints, they're useless unless you use them. We all need a plan for things if we want them to turn out a certain way. Today, I challenge you to spend some time this summer preparing more for the end of middle school instead of the beginning. What do you want to accomplish while you're in middle school? Do you want to be on a team, join a club, achieve academic excellence, or all of these? Once you know where you want to end, it is much easier to chart your course. Begin building your successful future now. Start thinking about the future you want to build so you can begin building the foundation. When you get to middle school, remember your goals and dreams. Try, work hard. Your teachers, parents, and family are there to guide you. But most importantly, you are in control of your destination. Your hard work and determination will get you there. One last thought. Walt Disney said, all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Decide now. You have the courage to pursue your dreams. You will work hard and you will be successful. Kyra Avant. Thank you.
Nicholas Hammett. Itzel Fernandez. Kayla Hidalgo.
We are so proud of all of the students in Ms. Colby's class. Thank you. And now we would like to have the students from Mr. Knapp's class please stand to be recognized.
Strangers, not even knowing what challenges may lie ahead. But once we got started, I knew that this class would be something very special. Not a day went by without seeing the joy of learning and the power of engagement, as well as the compassion and the caring hearts that each of my students shared throughout our journey of learning together. It is so hard to say goodbye to the individuals whom you admire and have become such a big part of your life. So instead, I will just say thank you for being such a wonderful class, and to also remind you that when you close this chapter in your great book of life, remember that you are starting a new one as you leave your elementary years behind and begin your new chapter known as middle school. Thank you for giving me the opportunity of being your teacher and helping you continue your lifelong journey into learning. I would like to close with a quote from one of my personal heroes, Walt Disney. Crowded classrooms are such a waste of our most precious natural resource, which is the minds of our children. Congratulations, I am so proud of you. Juliana Andrade. Jasmine Coughlin. Haley Daniels.
Baby.
Logan Farmer. Kaylana Griffith. Daniela Gudino Rios. Haley Hammonds. John Ibarra. Alan Kluckner. Adrian Lopez. Waltricia McGowan. Daniel Portillo. DeAndre Presendu. Michael Rex. Deuce Rose. Artemio Rubio. Elena Sanchez. Haley Whittington. Whytravius Woodson. And Chloe Wright. Congratulations.
Very proud of all of the students and Mr. Knapp's class. Thank you.
dying over here.
Good morning. Can everybody hear me okay?
Yeah.
Let me start off by saying, whoa. Fifth grade, it's coming to an end. Now, I've had the pleasure of working with your children to help them become the best person that they can be inside and outside of the classroom. We've been through a lot this year, but we have made great strides socially, behaviorally, and academically. Your children entered my classroom as fourth graders, and now they're leaving as sixth graders. I'm proud of them and believe that they are capable of doing great things in the future. I love all of you. I had a great time with each and every single one of you in class this year. Some of you may have not felt the same way, however, I never stopped loving you. Now, I'd like to thank the parents for all the support that I received from home. I could not have done the things that we accomplished this year without the support from you at home as well. So thank you. We were able to achieve great things in room 708. So thank you again for your help, parents and students. Best of luck in sixth grade. Rebecca Baserto. Denise Bautista. Asia Brown. Anna Lee Dubel. Daniel Heal. Antonio Jimenez Garcia. Trey Johnson. Malachi Knight. Diego Luna. Savannah Manning. Juan Mendoza. Jontel Maurice. Tiana Myers. Shelly Aurelian. Joanna Peralta Leon. Araceli Perez. Sarah Sandville. Willis Tumlin Jr. Makia Wilson. and William, we call him Bill, Yurix.
Great job, Mr. Richardson's class. Now we have the students from Simmons' class. And congratulations to the best fifth grade class at Lawnwood! I would just like to say a few encouraging words this morning. Fifth graders, this is your first transition to charting your course for the future. You would face many more transitions along this journey. Just always remember that knowledge is empowering. As you grow and mature, remember to learn from yesterday. Try not to repeat the same mistakes. Give your best effort today. What you do today counts. And hope, never stop believing that your hard work and determination will meet to propel you into your destiny. I say to you, go forth and be the best sixth graders ever. First, we have Ladarius Agnew. Next is Denise Augustine. Next, we have Jessica Alcantar. John Allen. Council Vice President Adrielle Dampier. Layla Desimon. Yoseline Gil Garcia. Juan Gush.
Sylvan Haynes. Tade Luna Barbosa. Anasia Lundy. Anthony Mendoza. George Olasawaga. Terry Rivers. Well, before I tell you real quickly, I want to take the time to congratulate all the parents, because we could not have done it without you, all the teachers, and of course, all the graduates. Congratulations to you. Now, briefly, let me tell you what CAP means in our class. The C, the letter C in the word CAP, stands for courageous. I know I have some courageous children. I just got these kids in November of last year, and they are very, very courageous, and I'm encouraging them to keep going. Be courageous. A, attitude. They can have an attitude. Have a positive attitude, right? So keep the attitude, but make sure it's positive. And finally, be persistent. Don't give up. No matter what the situation is, keep going. So as you move on to middle school, go and show them all you've got. Good luck. Bye-bye. Okay, first person. Zabiel Augustine. Santos Andre. Angelica Belmonte. Tiffany Klum. Logan Garrett. Amanda Hernandez. Robert Ingram. Is Landy Isaac. Priscilla Luna. Dontavian Meadows. Angelica Patterson, Angelina Patterson, Angelina, and good job, Angelina. I enjoyed your speech. I really. Nathaniel Reese. Stanley Revenge. Thank you.
Let's give the students and Ms. Barr McGahee's class a round. Now we'll move into the acknowledgement of special awards, and we will have not only our presidential awards and school-wide awards given, we'll have an address by our very own assistant principal, Ms. Lewis.
Good morning, students, families, and special guests. As your assistant principal, I feel so lucky to be here with you on this important day. Fifth graders, you did it. I remember some of you when you started kindergarten at Garden City, and others I have been fortunate to have met this school year. You are all unique, talented, special individuals, and I am proud of each of you. I am honored to be able to present two special awards, the Presidential Award of Excellence and the Presidential Award for Educational Achievement. The Presidential Award for Educational Excellence is given to students in order to recognize academic success by holding a GPA of 3.5 or higher in their third through fifth grade years, plus high achievement on the FSA or FCAT reading and or math exams. In addition, teachers recommend candidates to be recognized by the school's principal and the President of the United States. Here's the letter President Barack Obama provides for each student. Please accept my congratulations on receiving the President's Education Award. I am pleased to join your family, friends, and teachers in recognizing this tremendous achievement. Nothing will have a greater impact on your success and the success of our nation than the knowledge and skills you gain in the classroom. Your future is in your hands, and as long as you stay focused on your studies, there is not a single thing you cannot accomplish. By earning this award, you have shown the discipline and drive to excel academically, and I encourage you to carry those qualities forward in all that you do. Congratulations again. I applaud the example you set for students across our country, and I wish you all the best for the years ahead. President Barack Obama. For a student to receive this award, they have to be well-rounded and dedicated to putting forth good effort at all times. The following students are being recognized for outstanding achievement. From Mr. Knapp's class, Juliana Andre. Kaylana Griffin. Mia Morrison. Haley Hammonds. Adrian Lopez. Deuce Rose. Jasmine Coughlin. Haley Daniels. Daniela Rudino Rios. DeAndre Presendu. Waltravius Woodson. Artemio Rubio. Haley Daniel Portillo. Chloe Wright. John Ibarra. From Ms. Simmons' class, Mr. Knapp's class, who are receiving the Presidential Achievement Award. Congratulations to the students from Ms. Simmons' class. From Ms. Barr's class, Stanley Ravage. Congratulations to the student in Ms. Barr's class. In Ms. Coleman's class, Mariella Maya. Congratulations to the student in Ms. Coleman's class. The next award is for the President's Award for Educational Achievement. Recognize students who show outstanding educational growth, improvement, commitment, or intellectual development in their academic subject areas and have overcome challenges. The following students are being recognized in this category. For Mr. Knapp's class, Logan Farmer. Callan Kleckner. Waltricia McGowan. Michael Rex. And Elena Sanchez. Congratulations to the students in Mr. Knapp's class. For Mr. Richardson's class, Rebecca Basura. Denise Buista. Bautista. Malachi Knight. Tiana Myers. Shelly Aurelian. Araceli Perez. Johanna Bertilla Leon. And William Yurtz. Congratulations to all the students in Mr. Richardson's class. In Ms. Barr's class, Tiffany Klum. Angelica Belmontes. And Islande Isaac. Congratulations to all the students in Ms. Barr's class. In Ms. Cobble's class, Jacob Salinas. And Jasmine Bella. Congratulations to the students in Ms. Koble's class. And another congratulations to all the recipients of this Academic Achievement Awards. Thank you. And now we will have special recognitions of awards that are presented to our students who have earned perfect attendance for the entire school year, as well as the DAR awards and a special award given from our governor. So welcome to the podium our very own caring counselor, Ms. Tiffany Rowley.
Good morning. I want to start by saying congratulations to all of you fifth graders. This is the first of many accomplishments you guys have ahead of you. So I'm going to start with the perfect attendance all year. So these are given to students who have had perfect attendance for the entire 2015-16 school year. It takes a great deal of effort and dedication to mantle every single one of the 180 days. I commend your efforts. So I would now like to recognize Tiana Bruce. Thank you. So this next award are part of the Florida Good Citizenship Program and are given by the Sons of the American Revolution. It's a historical, educational, and patriotic non-for-profit corporation that seeks to maintain and extend the institutions of American freedom, an appreciation for true patriotism, a respect for our national symbols, and the value of American citizenship. These outstanding students, one boy and one girl, were chosen by their teachers and administration. They show qualities of dependability, leadership, patriotism, and character. We will now honor Stanley Revanche. And our girl is Kaylana Griffith. And this last award is going to be given to a student by our Governor Rick Scott. I'm going to read the letter he wrote to the student. Thank you for participating in the 2016 Black History Month Essay Contest, inspired by this year's theme, honoring African American heroes, African American veterans, military members, law enforcement officers, and first responders. As you learned about African American heroes who have made an incredible impact on our state, you also had the chance to learn about Floridians who have contributed to the safety of our state. African American heroes have made tremendous sacrifices and risked their lives to protect Floridians and free people all over the world. Your hard work in school this year will prepare you for your future success. I wish you great success throughout the school year. Sincerely, Rick Scott. And this award is going to Chloe Bright.
Let us give all the students with the special awards another huge round of applause. As we get ready to move into our musical selection, I just want to take a few minutes to say thank you so much for being a great audience and for recognizing all of the efforts of our young ladies and gentlemen.
Students, now we are going to move into our musical selection. We'll ask you to please stand. And our students are our future. We build a better world each day at a time. And in our theme, Building a Better Future, One Student at a Time, we know that this is our future. Our future is in great hands by all of the boys and girls who are getting ready to become great leaders, maybe even a teacher. And we are... A very special thank you to all of the people who have made this possible. Let's give it up for our sound crew in the back. And very special thank you to Ms. Lisa Stewart for making sure that the sound was going and our catcher memories were shown. Also, but also we want to say a very special thank you to our stage guest. Thank you. Our stage guest, we'll ask them to stand to be recognized. Our school board member, Ms. Debbie Holly. Our executive director, Ms. Lydia Martin. Fifth grade teachers. Face your audience.